there are some of the world's most in-demand tech jobs.
Oh, wow.
All right.
That was some precision right there.
So we'll be taking images of this entire elevation. That's the objective.
So we look for very key information. So this is what we are trained to do.
But what does a day in one of these roles actually look like? From rescue missions, filming travel videos, to inspecting buildings for signs of corrosion, they're all working with one technology, drones. This is Most Wanted. Kevin Chang is inspecting a building's facade to identify defects.
Okay, taking off.
Take off.
But sometimes, not everything goes according to plan.
My goodness, those are pigeons for sure. Are you landing, Kevin?
Yes, okay. Landing. So, it's a real case example. So, as you can see just now, there were a flock of pigeons.
Yeah.
The immediate action is for us to, of course, lower down to ensure they are gone before we continue.
From construction and real estate to transportation and defense, drone pilots are in demand across numerous sectors. They're even saving lives.
This is one of the remote stations which we deploy. The command center is here. The drone could be anywhere in the world. I'm trying to locate someone in the event that the person went missing.
I feel like I'm going to be on a stakeout.
Ng Ik Tong has piloted more than 20 rescue missions while serving as the chief technology officer at NECT Engineering.
So I'm looking for a man in his 40s, white shirt, supposed to be lost in the woods.
All right, so I'm going to move around to take a look at what my surroundings are like.
And right now, one of your colleagues is there.
Yes.
Posing as the victim.
Yes, indeed. Aha! So I see something here. I see a man, white shirt, in jeans. That should be you. You're the victim. I found you.
Yes, correct.
So when we find victims, they typically try to run away. So usually, we don't want to get too close. We just want to make sure that we are high enough.
Right now, we are tracking the victim.
Yes, we're tracking the victim. And of course, not to alarm the victim. So we just need to know where they are at all times until rescuers come.
Right now, you are capturing the coordinates?
Yes. The victim is not aware that they're being tracked.
So as not to scare them?
Indeed.
The world logged more than 20,000 hours of drone flight time per day in 2023. And there's one flying right now.
I'm going to trace the drone back to its pilot. Hey, Tong.
Is that Nessa?
Yes, I'm Nessa.
I'm in the air now. Let me come back and land.
Okay.
Tong Cheuk Fung specializes in flying FPVs, or first-person view unmanned aerial vehicles. This involves flying the drone from a pilot's perspective. And it's a lot more hands-on than conventional drone flying.
Usually, because they put a lot of technology inside, there are GPS, sensors, obstacle avoidance, compasses, barometers. So it's very well-assisted kind of drone flying the consumer will experience. Whereas for FPV drone, it's more like motocross, very agile. It's also very high demand on the rider, able to control it to go over different kind of terrains and in fast speed. So usually, when people think about drone filming, they will imagine a drone high up in the sky, like aerial photos, but I can also fly indoor and close proximity flights, close to people and close to objects safely. Wearing a goggle, it gives you a more immersive experience where you can make judgments a lot more accurately. Whether I want to make it shoot up with high acceleration or to let it drop down to make a dive using gravity. So all these are adrenaline pumping experience for me.
That rush is one reason more people are joining the industry, and Ik Tong is no exception. His drone journey began more than a decade ago.
I graduated as an electrical engineer, and then I converted myself to a defense scientist. That actually is the first time I get exposed to drones. At the point in time, drones were very new. DJI and the big brands were literally non-existent. So we started building drones from scratch, knowing that it would change the future of warfare. I started seeing more and more potential for drones to be involved in improving human lives.
After leaving the defense sector in 2015, Ik Tong decided to specialize in creating drone accessories. For example, there's one that transforms drones into lightning rods to protect high-priority equipment, and another which doubles a drone's flight time.
We have heated drone systems. So what it does is, it literally decouples the battery on the drone by putting the battery or the power source onto the ground, pump very high voltage through a very thin cable to the drone.
That link to Earth allows the drone to be deployed in locations that are traditionally demarcated as high-risk, no-fly zones, such as airports or roads.
Not only we can count vehicles, we can classify them into trucks, cars, motorbikes. We can tell the speed that is traveling.
Oh, wow.
If you want to trace a particular vehicle, then we will train the AI to look for it across the roads and only alert the user when that vehicle of that pattern appears.
Being a drone pilot isn't just about flying, but integrating technological advancements into their machines. AI is one such example that Kevin sees as integral to his work.
These are the images that we have collected today. What I'm supposed to do is to ensure the clarity of each respective images and then make sure there's sufficient overlap between the first image and of course the second image. Once this is done, we will go to a software where we make use of AI to pick up defects.
What are the most common defects?
Cracks, corrosion, spalling, and maybe some of the vegetation that's growing out from the facade itself. And of course, pigeons.
Were there any defects that you found in the images that we took earlier?
No, I don't think there are much defects, but I can show you some past samples. These are defects.
These are all defects? There's like dozens of them.
Correct. The traditional method is to make use of digital cameras, binoculars to collect all these facade images. And then for post-processing wise, they are supposed to screen through individual images to pick up defects on its own.
So no AI
involved? No AI.
It's just eye power?
Yes, correct. So you can imagine the amount of effort and time being wasted.
According to a drone market research firm, the commercial UAV market is expected to be worth more than $54 billion by 2030. As the applications for drones increase, so will the demand for pilots. Both Kevin and Tong made mid-career switches to be drone pilots after stints in business marketing and consulting respectively.
These tiny drones, I spent 6 months practicing every day, about 2 hours a day, crashing these things at home and scratch my walls. Usually for FPV pilot, we build our own drones. For this one, the manufacturer actually put it together for me. FPV is a very customizable thing. We choose our parts and we put them together. The parts come from different manufacturers and brands.
And how did you, you know, attain the skills to do that?
It's a lot of self-discovery, self-study, other pilots, forums, YouTube.
Tong also teaches drone piloting courses to adults looking to improve their skills or make mid-career switches like himself.
Teaching will help myself or other drone pilots will learn better, especially for drone or anything technology. You need to keep updating yourself. I think it's a good revenue for me to do that.
What do you see your students doing in the future?
Military, agriculture, delivery, logistics.
Public interest to adopt such technology is present. It's increasing across all sectors.
There's tons of applications, and I'm sure that a few years down the road, there'll be applications that we won't even be thinking of today.
We just have to ensure we touch on the privacy issue, safety aspect, the last one is practicality. So these three main points will kind of help to educate the users and even to our clients. Is this a right tool for you for the right job?
How fun is your job?
This is serious fun that goes beyond just flying our drones. Just engineering, you get to see many aspects of life, you get to work with many different agencies that you never get to. How often you get to work with Homeland Security to look for lost people. All these are experiences that you can't get anywhere else.